At 09:22 local time today, an American nuclear submarine, the USS Montana, with 156 men aboard, went down about 22 miles from here.
Damn.
There's been no contact with the sub since then. The cause of the incident is not known. Now, your company has authorized the Navy's use of this facility for a rescue operation, codenamed Operation Salvor.
You want us to search for the sub?
No. We know where it is. She's in 2,000 feet of water, and we can't reach her. We need divers to enter the sub and search for survivors.
Coming up next, Deep Sea Adventure featuring Ed Harris, Mary Elizabeth Mastrantonio, and an alien life force called the Abyss. And it's really two stories, and we're getting a lot of pictures that have two elements, and they don't blend well together. But one of them, I think, is very good. That's the story of an attempt to remove the nuclear missiles from a sunken atomic submarine. Leading the attempt are a couple of married and feuding undersea oil rig workers, played by Ed Harris and Mary Elizabeth Mastrantonio.
I was worried about the rig. I've got over 4 years invested in this project.
Yeah, you only had 3 years invested in me.
Well, you have to have priorities.
Underwater, the two of them have to deal with their crew, one of whom is paranoid about both the American and Russian military.
You know, we got Russian subs creeping around. Anything goes wrong down here, they could say whatever they want happen. Give the folks medals.
Relax, will you? You're making the women nervous.
Cute, Virgil.
But he's not completely paranoid, as the couple finds out when an American officer attacks them in a mini sub.
Go to the right. Swing to the right.
The underwater action is terrific, but the film goes aground when it tries for profundity with a close encounter with an E.T. clone.
I seem to be having a problem here.
The alien story really splits this movie in two, turning it from a hard-edged drama into a fairy tale that doesn't stand up by comparison with either Close Encounters, E.T., or 2001. Still, I enjoyed the main part of the movie, the claustrophobic tension underwater. I recommend it with a strong reservation about the creature from beyond. I wish they just built that whole idea.
I didn't mind the creature from beyond because it seemed to me that what it gave us was another level of fun for a movie that is basically a lot of fun, and I enjoyed this movie. When you said it was two stories, I thought you were going to say that the other story was the relationship between Harris and Mastrantonio, mm-hmm. whether or not they'll get back together again.
Well, that I know.
But I enjoyed that when she's trying to talk him through his, when he's going to have a panic attack when he's down at 40,000 feet.
That part I like.
Deep he was. This movie has great special effects.
Yes, it
convinced me that we were underwater.
Yes, it did.
And you could see what was happening. Oftentimes, they try to fudge underwater movies by putting everything in a big cloud of sand or something so that you can't see that it's only models or something. This movie looked good, and I thought it was very exciting. I thought the ending, of course, we could have taken the last 5 minutes and just not had them.
Didn't even look cheap.
It was photographed on bad stock or something. The ending was not the best part of the movie, but I enjoyed it. Another thing I liked, it was produced by this woman, Gail Ann Hurd,
right.
who also made Aliens, which starred Sigourney Weaver. And it's the same idea, which is that the action character, the leader of the group, is a woman. And that provides a whole different dynamic for the whole crew that is interesting. It makes a lot of the cliches seem a little fresher.
Yeah, but the problem is that the woman, at least in this case, I think, acts so macho that it gets a little corny.
Well, if you were the boss of an undersea oil rig and you were a woman, wouldn't you act a little macho when you're down there?
I probably would, but I'm watching it as a movie and I'm seeing it's a little bit out there. The problem for me is I say the alien stuff. Wouldn't you have liked the picture better if they hadn't had aliens down there and just spent more time with the rescue?
I just think they just put in another element that was more fun.
It doesn't work.
Come on, breathe, baby. God damn it, breathe. God damn you, bitch! You never backed away from anything in your life! Now fight! 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 Right now! Do it! Fight, God damn it! Fight! Fight!